Hey guys, it's Morgan coming to you with another Thursday Night Ride video, and it's going to be awesome. It is brutally hot down here in the valley. It is currently 96 degrees in Montrose. That is too hot for Montrose, Colorado, but you know what? That's the way it is. So, I just want to get, like, a lot of people who've only been to Montrose and ridden Peach Valley or Dry Creek, they always wonder how we can put up with it in the summer, because they know that it gets to be high 90s, low 100s here in the summer. And so this Thursday Night Ride video is all about showing you guys exactly how that works. So it is 5:13. We left the shop right at 5 o'clock, and it was 96, 97 degrees there. And now we are heading up to the Uncompahgre Plateau. The plateau, I think it's going to take us about 40 minutes to get up there. I'll check in when we get up there with the exact time and temperature and show you guys exactly how awesome Montrose, Colorado really is. Because on one extreme, it's super hot. We got desert and all that. And then you'll see. We're going tonight. After work, we're going to go ride in the mountains. So anyway, guys, if you like this video, if you're just joining us for the very first time, if you saw the thumbnail of something awesome happening on a dirt bike, make sure you consider subscribing to the channel, because we do everything from tech videos, tech tips, review videos of gear, parts, motors, things like that, and then ride videos like this one. So if that all sounds awesome, please consider subscribing. We're trying to grow this thing into a giant thing and help spread what we like to call the gospel of two wheels. So let's get after it. Uncompahgre Plateau. It is 5:40, so it took us exactly 40 minutes to get here from the shop. The shop is about 10 minutes north of town, so from town, you're right at about a half hour. And if you look right there, I don't know if you guys can see that in there, it's 74 degrees. So that is 22 degrees cooler right here. And yeah, guys, that's pretty awesome. There's not a lot of places where you can get off of work at 5 and go somewhere in 40 minutes that is 20 degrees cooler. So I'm pretty stoked. We're gonna have a ton of fun. I think I'll talk a little bit about what I'm wearing tonight, because I've been trying out the climb Mojave Jersey, and I've got the climb Dakar pants. So we'll take a look at that, and then we'll get suited up and get ready to rock and roll. All right, guys, there we go. There are the Dakar pants and the Mojave jersey. Mojave is the most vented jersey they make. It is crazy vented. You can see right through it. The Dakar pants are one level less vented, which I like for pants. Generally, pants, the super vented stuff is just a little too lightweight. Although I'm super impressed with the Climb Mojave jersey. It is not torn at all. I've worn it quite a few times. I've worn it racing. Crashed in it, I've hit lots of trees, branches, things like that. So far, the thing has been perfect. The pants I raced in, and they were rad. So yeah, let's go ahead and let's get those things on. Let's go for a ride. All right, ready to rock and roll. Might as well get them all. I put a new chain on today, so hopefully it's even faster. Woof, woof.
Yeah. Yep. It's on now. Yeah.
Custom make that holder? Or?
No, dude. Up in Oregon makes them. It just bolts here and then to the fender there, and it's like
cool, man.
Brilliant. It can hold a way bigger saw than this too. So. My official, like, criteria for whether I cut it or not is if I expect my children to go over it, then I don't cut it. That'll keep it single tracky.
Oh yeah.
I know, there's a bunch of it. So
yeah.
So some of these are brand new, but keep your eye out as we go through here because there's a ton of stuff from the 30s.
30s?
Yeah, from the 30s. Like that's probably super, super old because they were sheep herders. They're Basque sheep herders that were through here. And they carved up these trees, and there's like all these like naked women and all kinds of stuff through here.
There's something right there on that one.
Yeah, well, that looks.
A bunch of them.
Yeah, well, they're everywhere. So as we go through these forests, like this trail goes right through the heart of it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
fender.
Nice.
That's the good time to start picking up the
Exactly. Might as well grab that one too, real fast. Let's roll it. Here, hang on.
Mike, you're a go-getter, you know that?
No, I don't know.
You're a go-getter. I like these ones. Yeah. You gotta do it like the last dark center. We go flip over like sideways and then flip over that way. Can you lift up on this side, Ryan? Yeah, first, so he can get underneath. There we go. Okay, so now you let off. Well, yeah.
You're 20 as far as I'm concerned.
That's what I'm saying. Out of my way, sheets! Oh, man. I'll tell you right now, this Mojave Jersey is awesome once you get moving. I mean, it's hot doing all this work, but once you move at all, this Jersey breathes so well. Definitely better than any other vintage Jersey gonna end up being way tougher, which is awesome. Because I've had some other vintage jerseys that were, they were good. And you know, this reads really well too, but you know, you brush against a tree or even kind of look at one halfway cross-eyed, you end up getting a tear in the arms. But the arms on these are much stronger material than the rest of it.
GoPro of all these beautiful pink roses.
Oh yeah. Doing work.
One more.
I know. One would eat some people's lunch right there.
Yeah, don't suck you all the way down, take a ride.
Come back if you can. There we go.
Don't let it run you over.
Yeah. Yeah, it might not have been. Let's see. I'm gonna start on this side if you guys move that thing. Oh, watch out. Yeah, there you go.
Here.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yeah. Watch out, Mike. I'm gonna try kicking it. Oh, we're gonna get out.
Ryan said he wanted to spend the night.
Yeah.
Hey, I got a Garmin. Should I push my button?
Yeah, not yet.
Big splash in that creek.
Yeah, I tried to jump that thing. I was like,
good ride, Mike.
That was an awesome ride, boss. Oh my god,
my favorite part was clearing the trees.